So we're going through these videos here, and we're going to learn about measuring bits in this video, and I'm just going to preview that code right off the bat. So we're going to do some bit shifting here in the Go programming language, and then we're also going to see how to use Iota, and we're going to combine Iota with bit shifting to calculate kilobyte, megabyte, gigabyte, terabyte, petabyte, exabyte, right there. And this is all part of a series of videos, so you can find the link for the playlist in the description. And we looked at how computers work, how they, you know, work on switches and on-off states, and how if it's we represent those on-off states as zeros and ones, and we use coding schemes, create coding schemes, so when switches or circuits or transistors, call it what you will, are in certain arrangements of on or off, that represents like a letter or a color or a sound. And we use the analogy of a porch light on Halloween, and if the light's on, it means one thing, come trick-or-treat, and if it's off, it means another thing, go away, right? And so that switch, the porch light, in an on-off configuration, if it's on, it has a coding scheme, and that coding scheme means one thing, come trick-or-treat, and if it's off, it means something else, go away. And so and then we learned about numeral systems, binary, decimal, and hexadecimal, since we are talking about on-off zeros and ones. We looked at the binary numbering system and then, you know, talked about those different numeral systems and how the base, how we figure out how to build a numeral system and work with a numeral system based upon the base, 10 to the power 0, 10 to the power 1, 10 to the power 2. So if you want to check out those videos, go look at that playlist after this video or go start at the beginning of that playlist and watch those and then come to this. Because in this one, we're going to look at measuring bits. It all kind of is leading up. You know, we learned about bits, zeros and ones, binary digits here. And then we learned about the binary numeral system here. And now we're going to learn about measuring bits here. And so that's kind of cool just to see how to do that in the Go language. And then the next videos after this one in the playlist, we're going to look at ASCII, Unicode, and UTF-8. That's super important to understand those three things and characters and runes in the Go programming language. And then the video after that, we'll have a palindrome challenge. And that's going to be totally fun. I'm looking forward to sharing that with you. All right, so for this video here, though, we're going to take a look at how to calculate kilobyte, megabyte, all that stuff using bitwise operations and then also using Iota. And so for bitwise operations, what this is saying, let me just run this because it's easier to understand if you see it run. So right now I'm in 00-ai-bitwise dot whatever, all that. And this is in my repo, and that repo, you could check out that code here. If you get to GitHub and goes to 11, you could go to repositories. And in this repository, I have the Learn to Code Go version 0.3 course. And in this course, I have 0.0.0. These are all like the setups, things I just do, kind of thinking about code. And then this is all the code for the course. But in here we have, what is it? 0.0. AI Bitwise Ops 01, and I haven't pushed up the other packages, the other code, the other files, so we'll do that as soon as I'm at the end of this, we'll see that. So I'm going to run this code here, and here you can see the bit is shifting over. Here I'm at the zeros place, 2 to the power 0. Here I'm at 2 to the power 1, right, which is the 2's place. And 2 to the power 1, when we are looking at our numeral system, right, here's the 1's place, 2 to the 0, and we have 0, we have 1, 1 there, and so that's 1. And so here it is in decimal, and here it is in binary. And then we shift over one bit from the ones place to the twos place, and we have one in the twos place. And with one in the twos place right here, then decimal, that's two. And then we shift the bit over one more into the fours place, right? So here we are in the fours place, and in decimal, that's four. In binary, that's four. And then we shift the bit over one more, and this is coming to the eights place, right? And so, come on, I can't select a single one. And so we have one in the eights place, right? As we shift the bit over in decimal, that's eight. And then we shift it over one more to the 16's place, the 32's place, 64's place, the 128's place, the 256's place, the 512 place, and the 1024. And so 1024 bytes is a kilobyte. It's 1,000 bytes. And so that is shifting the bit over one at a time to represent in binary this number here. As it's represented there is in decimal, right? The decimal numbering system. And so the code to do that that shifting is right here. And so right at the very beginning, we just have one, and we're printing that out as binary. And we have some padding here, some leading zeros, so that I get this nice sort of arrangement right here where you could actually see through those zeros and ones the bit shifting across it. So I added padding there just to make it look that way. And we're starting out with one in the first place right there, okay? And then we shift the bit over one, and when we shift the bit over one, it goes over to this place right there. And so then we just keep shifting over. We shift over two, and we shift the bit over two, and it goes to that place. And so that's how you use Bitwise operations. Play with it a little bit till you get comfortable with it. But there's the code. You could grab the code off of GitHub, and you can fool around with it. And then here we have Iota, because we're going to combine Iota with our Bitwise shifting, right? So we're going to say, hey, shift this over some amount to a multiple of 10. And so what Iota does is Iota will start at zero, and this is just a Go programming language mechanic. It's an idiom that you can use. And Iota will just increment by a small amount. Iota means a small amount. It's actually the smallest letter in the Greek alphabet. Iota is the smallest letter in the Greek alphabet. And so here we're like, just give me one more iota. Just give me one more, right? Just give me one more. And so you start out at zero, and then you get one, and then you get two, and then you get three, and then you get four, and then you get five. And if we run this and print out those values right there, and so I'm just going to CD and go up a level and go into the second one here, go run main.go, I'm going to get 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Well, we could use that characteristic of iota right here. And so we're going to throw away our first, we're creating a constant, and we're going to throw away our constants. We're going to throw away our first iota of 0, because the first iota right there is 0. We're just going to throw that away to the blank identifier. And then we're going to say, hey, 1 times 10, and bit shift over 10 spaces. Because when we bit shift over 10 spaces, right, and you can see we bit shift over 10 spaces there, and we bit shift over 10 spaces there, we get 1024, and 1024 is a kilobyte. And actually the way it goes is like, you know, it's factors of 2 to the power of 10 between kilobyte, megabyte, gigabyte, terabyte. So for each one of these, we want to go over 1 to the 1, we want to go over 10 here, and then we want to go over 20 here, and then we want to go over 30 here, and then we want to go over 40, and then 50, and then 60. So each one, 2 to the power of 10, just going to the next 1024, we just do 1 times 10, 2 times 10, 3 times 10. So iota goes from 1 to 2 to 3 to 4 to 5 and multiplies by 10 and then shifts over. And you can see byte size here is our type, and it's an int. So just to note that. And so let's run this, and we'll see it calculate kilobyte, megabyte, gigabyte, terabyte, all that. So I'm going to CD and go up to 000-AI, and this is going to be 3. That's kind of a cool just coincidence. It has nothing to do with artificial intelligence. It's just my own random naming numbering scheme. And we're going to do a go run main.go. And there it is. And so here we have kilobyte in decimal, and here we have it in binary. And we saw how we got to that binary right there, right here, right? And then we have megabyte, which is just 10 more zeros. It shifted over 10. And then we have gigabyte, which is just 10 more zeros. It shifted over 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, right? So each one's just shifting over 10 more, and terabyte and petabyte. And this is the actual number of bytes. If we want to know the bits, we just multiply that by 8. So that might be a fun little exercise. Just multiply it all by 8, and you'll see the actual number of bits of binary digits of single zeros and ones that are in an on-off state when you're storing like this much data. So that's pretty incredible. Computers are incredible. I'm humbled to just even like, you know, look at what humans have created and to be able to contribute to it in a small amount by helping other people and myself understand it. So computers are pretty amazing. All right, last thing I want to show you is just our game plan. In the next video, we're going to take a look at ASCII, Unicode, and UTF-8 and learn about runes and learn about all those. So in the Go programming language. So if you want to check that out, make sure you hit that subscribe button. And you'll be notified when that video comes out. And also, if you like this video, hit that thumbs up and leave a comment down below. That actually motivates me to be like, all right, I'm going to make another video. It's benefiting people. So hit that like and subscribe and leave a comment down below. And it motivates me to make these videos. Anything else? I don't know. I think that's it. See you in the next video.